This is John Cole with growingyourgreens.com. Today we're going to do a very special update to my watering system. So I have this water timer. It's a Rainbird water timer, ISA 304. It's a four station timer, and it's a pretty dumb timer, and it's pretty hard to set, like most of them are. They're not made by people for people. They're made by engineers for people, and that doesn't work usually. So every time we have to program it, literally we have to get the instruction manual out of the house or print one off from online. They're available online as PDF files, and then read through it and figure it out. So that was kind of bunk. It's a pain. I mean, it does work. Oh, and it does limit you on the timer program. So you could have four stations, a number of programs, but sometimes you have to repeat the same program, and it doesn't allow you to have different stations on different programs. So they're not that flexible. But I think this unit about 10 years ago when it was installed was about $20. So we got the upgraded model here, taking us into the 21st century. Let's go ahead and pull this out. This one retails for about $100, but I got it on a clearance sale for, I think it was about $40. And this one's basically a touch screen. This is like the fake screen thing on there. But yeah, it's a touch screen. Has all these different features. Uses a stylus, backlit display. Actually, you could hook up a rain sensor to it, so it'll stop actually watering when it's raining outside. It actually has a USB connection, so you could plug it into your computer and program it that way, and hopefully won't have to read the instructions again to program it. So it's really easy to do this, and basically you could see there's a couple things you need. You basically just plug it into the wall. So there's an outlet adapter with this unit. We'll plug it into the wall right here. And the only other things you have to do is change these wires. So we could go ahead and pull this off and show you. These timers are really easy. They run on a 24 volt system. So it has basically an AC adapter that converts 120 volts down to 24 volts. And then they usually have a backup battery, so in case the power goes out, it saves the time and your program. That's very important. Has a built-in fuse for overloads. And then basically there's just four wires. And the four wires are simply one wire goes to each valve to control the on-off, and then there's a common wire as well. So here's labeled common, valve 1, 2, 3. And this unit contain up to four valves. And this one can take up to 16 valves. So this one, what is a valve? Well, the valves are back over here hidden. And this controls all the water to the beds. So these valves here basically turn on and off, and each one of these valves go to a specific bed. So if you have 16 beds, you might want to have 16 valves, but that might be a waste because some of these valves actually go to multiple beds. So, you know, you just have more flexibility. Say you want to have a tomato bed and you want to water that bed, you know, every other day. If you have another bed on that same line, it's going to also get watered every other day. So if you have an area where you want to plant certain things, it's good to have different valves so you have the most flexibility on watering. We want to try to water the tomatoes every other day and see how that's going to work, but then that's going to affect some of the other beds over here. So we're going to plant things that are like tomatoes that could deal with water every other day, such as the herb bed and some tomatillos and ground cherries, which are basically in the same family. So how many valves? It's up to you. We're putting in our friend's place here upcoming, and he's having one valve for pretty much this raised bed setup. He's putting in about three beds, and he's going to have one valve on it. But yeah, one valve could easily handle the distribution of a lot of water, but it's just how much flexibility do you want. So we'll be back in a minute, and we'll show you the update with this all installed. Literally, all we have to do is unscrew the old unit, undo these wires, connect it to this one, plug in a new AC adapter, and mount it up, and we'll be ready to go. We got the Orbit Signature Irrigation Control Timer installed. It's working very good. It's very easy to use. It only has two buttons. It's a total touch screen, so you just touch the screen, you do what you want to do, and you could change all the programming. It's really easy to program, unlike some of the other ones that have dials, and it's really straightforward and easy to use. You could plug this into the USB and program it by your computer, and there's also a rain sensor. So right now we don't have the rain sensor installed, but I'm going to install the rain sensor so that now the system will not water when it's actually raining, because it'll detect that it has been raining, and then it will actually not turn itself on. So I hope you've learned more about water irrigation timers. We do have this mount on the side of the house under an eave, but I recommend that you also, you know, get a box for it, because the timers can be damaged by moisture. So this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. Keep on growing.